Okay, so first of all, we're going to be using quite a big flat brush. We're going to be completely painting this canvas navy blue. So I've got this blue here, and this will be perfect for it. So if you just keep using the same brush again, but get a good wipe, put a bit of black onto your palette. So for this one, this part, if you can see the black on that, it's not an awful lot. It's just like one dip into my paint, and that should be enough. So you want to put a black line across the top here, and just start working your way down with the black, and it'll start blending in with the blue. And I'll just dip in some more black here. It's not covering as much as I would like. So if we get something like that, that should be fine. So the next part we're going to be doing here is the rocks and mountain effect. So again, we'll be using black for that one. And I would just use the same brush. So this is actually good for putting straight lines in if we hold it that way. You know, putting quite good for fine lines. So we're going to get the shape of these mountains in, maybe come from about here. So once you've got the general shape in here, we're going to paint it completely black. So once you've got that the general shape in, it's just a case of letting it dry. So if you have a hairdryer, you want to speed things up, do that. So the sides where the top of your mountain is, I'm going to go over here and just bring it down like that. And so we're just gonna a rough kind of outline just now. So then we'll get a palette knife. This is great for texture and getting a kind of rocky look. So we'll start bringing the palette knife in from the side here. You see this kind of texture it's causing here, you can see it instantly. That's what we're looking for. That'll give you a nice kind of textured effect. Now we'll leave a wee space between this bit down here. If you get a really small and a flat brush like this, and I've mixed a wee bit of blue, very, very light, just put a bit of white on your palette and a wee touch of blue and you get this nice tone. And once you've done that, dab another a wee bit of white into this, or just to break it up a wee bit. Right, now I've got this brush here, which has quite hard bristles on it. It's not soft as your other brushes. And this is good for doing kind of dabbing on wee areas, like so. Maybe I've got too much snow here that I don't like, I would just put a wee bit of black on and break it up using this. So it's, that brush is ideal for that kind of thing. Maybe we've got up here. Then I'm going to get a wee bit more white on my brush and just kind of touch up. And there we have one snowy mountain landscape painting.